San Antonio shook just a little bit with an earthquake registering 3.7 southeast of the city earlier in the day. That was about 4:50 this morning. Hate to tell you, at about 9 o'clock tonight, the noise inside the Alamo Dome maybe register about a 5.5. Hey, how are you folks? Jason Horowitz, Pete Gillen, Steve Lapis, CBS College Sports. Now, we're glad to be with you on Destination San Antonio presented by Coors Light as we finish off the week leading up to the championship game. Guys, you've had 2 days to figure out the key matchups, the key players. It's all sunk in. What's the key matchup for tonight?
Well, I think the big thing that Memphis has to do, I think, is pound the offensive glass, because Kansas has great help defense, so that everybody's going to converge to the ball. So go to the offensive glass, really pound the offensive glass. And the second thing they got to do, I think, is score in transition. It's really get out in a break, because once again, Kansas, when they get the defense set, when they build the wall, they're very tough. So those are the things that they have to do, I think, is pound the glass and score in transition. Now, for Kansas, I think they got to slow down the big two, Derrick Rose and Chris Douglas Roberts. You got to slow them down. Those guys are wrecking machines, whether you play some zone, Steve, you know, Jay, or, you know, a little triangle in two. He went to a little box in one, as we saw against Davidson. And the other thing I think they got to do is take care of the basketball, because a lot of turnovers, you know, CDR and Rose are great hands, so they can't turn the basketball over. So if Kansas does that, they got a shot.
Steve, he brought up a good point, the fact that they can't stop Rose and Douglas Roberts. There has to be some other way to do it. Now, everyone always talks about forcing them to take outside shots. How do you do it?
Well, you know, it's a lot easier said than done, that's for sure. Now, one of the differences is Brandon Rush. He's kind of an X factor here in that Chris Douglas Roberts, for the first time really in the tournament, is going to be looking at somebody eye to eye who's also more physical than him. Brandon Rush can stay in front of Chris Douglas Roberts, so that could bring some problems for him. But let's face it, Roberts and Rose have been absolutely the best players in this tournament. Somebody on Kansas must slow them down somehow.
Well, that's defensively. How about offensively? Who's got to be the guy? Because they're going to have to score with Memphis as well. They're great defensive teams on both sides of the ball. Kansas is going to have someone step up again.
Yeah, I think Chalmers got to step up. He's got to be able to make some shots. Brandon Rush, I think, is a terrific offensive player, but I think Chalmers got to hit some shots. He's potential. Russell Robinson will score a little bit, but I think Chalmers got to really step up. So I think that's important, you know, and they got to score in transition also, get some easy baskets, but I think Chalmers a big guy. My thing is, I don't think they can guard CDR. I don't think they can guard him. Brandon Rush can't move side to side. He had the big knee surgery. Remember that, Steve? I don't know how he's playing. You know, he must be a bionic man, but I think that it's going to be trouble here, you know, guarding him. I think they got to cheat off Antonio Anderson, make him pay, Steve, you know what I mean, and double up CDR and also Derrick Rose.
Well, there's no doubt that the big thing here also is that the inside game of Kansas is very strong. Terrell Arthur, Darnell Jackson, Cole Aldrich we got to throw in there now after what he did the other day, and Sasha Kahn. I think they have a big edge when it comes right there. That's where Memphis could get hurt. Even though Taggart came off the bench, played very well, Dorsey played a very dominant defensive game, still didn't score any points. I think where they have to find, I think Kansas has the better balance. This is what they have to rely on tonight, is getting some from the perimeter, some from the big guys, because really Memphis right now, I don't know who does it if Rose and CDR don't do it.
Yeah, that's the actual point, because inside there's not a big scorer. John Calipari has said the entire week that Robert Dozier has to be a key. He has to step up. We'll see if that happens. So it sounds like Memphis has the advantage on the outside, Kansas the advantage on the inside. I think we've known that going in. You guys have had 2 days to pick your winners. Let's let them be known. Memphis going for its first national title. Kansas, its third. Who do you got?
I got Memphis. I picked them before the tournament. Last time I was right, the Red Sea was certainly a dead sea, and it was not alive. But I'm going with them. I think they're very athletic, and I think Memphis Tigers will be cutting down the nets, but I was scared when I watched Kansas.
Well, I'm going to have to go with Pete. I'm going Memphis. I'm not as smart as Pete, because Pete did this a long time ago before.
I'm a lot older.
I've been waffling. There's no doubt. I had UCLA earlier, but really, this Memphis team right now is playing too good. They have the two hottest guys in the tournament on their team. Dorsey looks like he's in a good frame of mind. I think it's Memphis.
All right, he's taking Memphis. Right. I think you're both wrong. It's Kansas. Destination San Antonio, presented by Coors Light from the Alamo Dome. Enjoy the championship game right here in this building. The road ends here for one of the teams. Goes on to championship glory for the other. Take care, folks.